Hey guys, X here, and I'm back with another quick tutorial. This time we're looking at Risk of Rain 2's brand new 1.0 launch update, and we're going to show you guys how you can unlock the latest survivor, the Captain. Don't go anywhere, we're just getting started. Before we get started, I'd be remiss if I didn't encourage you wonderful people out there to like and subscribe and comment below what your favorite addition to the 1.0 update is thus far. The newest survivor, the Captain, is unlockable by beating the game. Now, this can be done on any difficulty with any survivor. So for all intents and purposes, I recommend doing this on Drizzle and picking a survivor you're most comfortable with. This run will be running with the Huntress, who has incredible mobility and has very easy to use auto-aim targeting as well. To beat the game, you need to reach the final level after Sky Meadow and defeat the final boss, Mithrix. Now, Mithrix is no joke and has a pretty dangerous kit of abilities and attacks. The Huntress comes in clutch with her teleport and high vaulting abilities to help her dodge these attacks, which is why we're using her for this run. The first thing you need to do is to get to the fifth stage, Sky Meadow. You'll notice a little message that says, "The primordial teleporter aligns with the moon." Okay, that's nice. Well, what the heck even is that? Once you locate the primordial teleporter, you'll notice it has a different kind of frame surrounding the original teleporter. Don't activate this. This is going to send you through another cycle on the planet instead of teleporting you to where you need to be, which is a new sort of transitional area called Commencement. Now, Commencement is a linear level whose purpose is specifically just to get you through to the final area to fight Mithrix and beat the game. Once you've arrived, all you need to do is approach the little black hole thingy and Mithrix will spawn in. He will immediately charge at you, so be ready for some evasive maneuvers because he hits hard, even on Drizzle. So you can see here, he kind of charged in and he immediately tries to smash me with his hammer. And I'm just blasting away at him, trying to keep my distance as much as possible. Because he does follow up with several different kinds of attacks. The main one that you want to watch out for is this one right here, where he's jumping in and he's going to make a giant shockwave all throughout. And that thing will almost kill you, if not one-shot you. So be very careful there. He will also charge at you with sort of a range attack as he's dashing at you. And if he can get a swing of his hammer off at you, he will launch you into the air like so. So you want to be super careful, especially in this first phase, because this gets a little tricky. But at least here you get to kind of know his kit a little bit and his abilities while just kind of wailing away at him with your attacks. This is why I prefer Huntress particularly, because she has incredible mobility. Her teleports can really save you like that. And the shockwaves are not as much of a threat. But if you're a character like Rex or, the Commando, someone who doesn't have a whole lot of mobility innately, then you might want to try and find yourself a Hapu Feather or something that can help you jump higher to get over those shockwaves. And I should be finishing him off just now and bumping into phase two. Now, phase two is interesting. Mithrix is actually nowhere to be found in this particular phase, but there are a bunch of Lunar Chimera that spawn, and you want to be careful because they can actually hit super hard. So these flying ones, the flying Lunar Chimera, they can hit you with these machine gun style attacks, where these ground-based tank style ones can do these charge up burst attacks that can do some significant damage. So be super careful with that. And once you've killed all the Chimera and mowed them down, Mithrix will spawn back in for phase three. And when Mithrix spawns in, he has the same kit as he had in the previous first phase, except he has a couple new attacks. One is this frontal tonal ground slam attack you gotta be very careful of. He also drops sort of a tornado whirlwind style beam you don't wanna walk into after he slams, just like that. Don't walk into that, it's gonna hurt. And he also has, he does have his standard shockwave ability when he jumps and slams down, so jump over that, but he also is going to do something else where he kind of spins around and drops these beams, these giant ground markers you'll see, and if you get hit by one of those, it does a lot of damage just like that, so be super careful not to walk into that, not to accidentally teleport into it. I've done that a couple times already. That's probably the most devastating thing. And he also has a couple of Lunar Chimera adds, which can actually be used to your advantage, especially as the Huntress. Just throw your glaive and let it bounce around and do some work on Mithrix. So once you have cleared Mithrix of this phase, we move into the fourth and final phase of the fight. Now, this is probably one of the scarier phases of the fight because Mithrix has a special thing he does where he steals all of your items and uses them for himself. So you're going to want to adapt your play style against Mithrix right now, because remember, he does have your items. He has different effects and different things that he can do with those items. So if you have something like the Genesis Loop, you're definitely going to want to keep your distance when he gets low HP, because he's going to be exploding and blowing up, or, you know, keeping that line of sight. But if you have different kinds of items like Kiarra's Band or Runald's Band, make sure you take extra care not to get hit. And if you get hit by Kiarra's Band attack, stay out of that Flame Cyclone, because it's going to hurt real bad. Vithrix is also going to toss out these little lightning orbs that are going to be spinning around the map, and they really hurt a lot when they hit you. And as you see right there, he did drop the Kiarra's Band little Flame Cyclone that I got hit by. But notice that as I'm attacking him, I'm getting items back. So you want to keep your attacks up, keep hitting him as much as possible, and you'll keep getting items back that you can use against him as he will be dropping them. Once you've completed and beaten him, this is actually the end of the boss fight, but it's not the end of the game just yet. The final phase of the game, once you've defeated Mithrix, is the moon's going to explode. So you have to escape the moon, and this is a very Metroid-style end of the game, where you need to escape on the ship and run through the level. And as you're running through this level, there's going to be Lunar Chimera spawning, and there's also going to be these Void Reavers that spawn in. And if you remember Void Reavers from previous runs and before this launch update, they would spawn in and they drop these little areas of effect that can definitely hurt and obliterate a lot of your HP. So don't step in those. I just was running past everything and ignoring everything, because you do have about a 4-minute timer to get off the planet. I wasn't sure, so I just kind of skedaddled and ran through. So this is another reason why the Huntress is so great for this, because she has a lot of mobility, a lot of teleporting she can do. She can go up pretty high places, and it makes escaping the moon very, very easy. So once you approach this ship that's just awaiting you, it's surrounded by a couple of these fighting drones defending it. You will fly away to safety, and you will have beat the game, thus unlocking the Captain, which is the brand new survivor added to the game. And packs quite a punch. I will make another video about the Captain and his kit, and just talking about the best ways to use him, maybe some best builds for him as well. But thanks for watching, guys. This has been the short walkthrough of how to beat Risk of Rain 2 with the 1.0 launch update has released, and unlock the brand new survivor, the Captain. Make sure once again to drop a like, subscribe, and comment below of your favorite part of this update that you enjoy, Risk of Rain 2. My name is Excellion. You can find me on Twitter at @Excellion_, Instagram at @Excellion. You can follow me on my Twitch channel as well, twitch.tv/Excellion. And I will catch you guys later on.